doing like, you know, that he's doing with, he used to do with his students, going out to the fields to receive the challah. We are like doing a preparation for that. My question is about something that I read from the Rambam. The Rambam says, please correct me if I'm saying wrong, that Jesus and also Muhammad were part of the plan of Hashem. Have you ever read that?
No. I don't need to read this. Because for me, it's obvious that everything is part of Hashem.
Of course, but you know, I'm talking about Avodah Zarah.
I say everything.
For there's the
no
angel.
Listen, I say again, everything. There's no exception.
Of course, yeah, but
everything is part of the plan of Hashem.
You know, these two persons are like, you think whatever, but
doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Everything, the Holocaust and all the religions and all the bad things that happened to the humankind from the beginning until now, and in the future, Chas v'Shalom. Everything is the plan of Hashem.
Yeah, but how come? How come the Rambam can say that? Also, Yehi Si and
there's no other possibility. There's no other possibility. It cannot be something that is outside of the plan of Hashem.
Of course, I understand that. But how to apply it? How to explain it? Is what I want to know.
Just like I said it. I don't understand the question.
Yeah, but a specific case, you know. We know that also that when there is a terrorist attack, it's part of the plan of Hashem.
No.
We understand that. But how to explain that these two persons are part of the plan of Hashem?
I've read something about that. Someone was talking about it the other day. He's saying that the reason why Rambam thinks they're good is because they introduce those people to the concepts of like charity and kindness and the principles of Mashiach.
So the principle of Mashiach.
Right.
Oh, that's
and charity.
That's
and they're saying good things. I mean, because, I mean, they've been pretty terrible to Christians over the years, but generally speaking, without Christianity or Islam, things would probably be in a whole lot worse.
Yeah, because how we would know about the concept of Mashiach?
Exactly.
If they don't show up something.
Right,
like
right. So he holds it, he just shows them like good things about Hashem in general, you know. I mean, what they've done with him is up to them, but something like that. But Yaakov Ken was saying something about it the other day.
It's also true. Yeah. The Rambam says that. They prepare the world for Mashiach. In the conceptual state of mind of the people. But that's like, you can give reasons why it's good, why something is good. But the truth is, we cannot understand anything about the plan of Hashem. Okay? Not only the bad things we cannot understand, also the good things. Yeah? If Hashem gives you a candy, so you don't need explanation. You think in your mind, it's natural. Hashem likes me, so he gives me a present. You find 100 shekel on the street. You don't say, why? But if you lose 100 shekels, you say, oh, Hashem, why you did this to me?
Yes? So I never say why.
Not you, someone else. Okay? So there is...
I think if you say why, you're like, you know, but if you say what for, you know, it's like he will give
okay,
you...
Okay, that's good. What you're saying is good. But I'm saying the same concept is like the good and the bad is really the same question. We want to know why Hashem is doing whatever he's doing, good or bad, right? But the real answer is we don't understand Hashem. We can't understand Hashem. So it's not something that they can tell you, this is because that. We cannot understand Hashem, period. Hashem is above us. Yes, when I'm doing something, so somebody looks at me and he thinks, I know the reason why he did this, because this and that and this and that. But he doesn't know, right? So if you don't understand your friend, even yourself, usually we don't understand ourselves. But we don't understand our friend, so for sure we cannot understand Hashem. right?
You understand your wife?
If let's you know about there's many people that they are very involved in politics, and they're criticizing the leaders. Ah, this leader, he did this because it's not good what he did, but they don't really understand all the things that he have in mind that he made this decision, right? They have a reason why they criticizing him, but they don't understand all the whole picture. The Gemara says that there's no, the like someone that is not a leader cannot understand the reasons behind something that a leader does. You understand? And there's many like levels on that, and obviously Hashem is above everything. He's above like all the leaders, but even a human leader, we don't understand. The Gemara says about human. I'm saying it's the same thing, and how much more so, right?
He has another question.
Okay.
Question night.
Okay,
this is an ambiguous question.
Okay.
What?
Two meanings.
La primera es, bueno, que en esta parasha, ¿sí? Se habla de cómo se llegó al arco, ya sabemos. Y que Hashem le dijo la zarza. Bueno.
ברוך השם, מה קורה עם אבא שלך? ברוך השם, יופי, אני שמח לשמוע. פללנו עליו, קיבלנו עליו, אני שמח ש... ברוך השם. טוב, ברוך השם, ברוך הבא. אני, כרגע אני בבית מדרש של התפוסות בינתיים. אני מלא...
Okay, I have a miscall.
בסדר,
so
בסדר.
כל
טוב, להתראות. Okay, ברוך השם. Do you know Shlomo, the cook?
Yeah.
So, that is his brother, he used to learn here. So, both of them came to me today that their father went to the hospital.
And they
asked me to daven for him. So, now he said that Baruch Hashem, he came out of the hospital. Baruch Hashem, he feels better.
Wow.
And he's coming to learn, Baruch Hashem. Okay, good. Okay, so what was the question again? What was the question? What was the question?
Reveal his name to Moshe through the tree with fire. How do you say tree with fire?
The burning bush.
The burning bush.
Quiero saber dos cosas.
He wants to know two things.
Número
uno. Number one.
La Torah no había sido entregada.
Torah wasn't revealed before.
Pero en ese momento Moshe ya poseía conocimientos de la Torah.
But at that moment Moshe already knows about the Torah. This is the first question.
Sí, y la segunda pregunta de eso es que se supone que obviamente Moshe tenía un nivel más grande.
You know that Moshe Rabbeinu have a really high level.
Sí. Y un comentarista de la parasha decía el día de hoy, se me olvidó el nombre,
aquí voy from a commentary of the parasha today,
que aprendemos de esta parasha,
that we learned from this parasha,
que hay unos principios, no, si hay unos requisitos para que una persona sea, digamos, mekubal.
And there is many requirements for people to be a mekubal.
Sí. Entonces, la segunda pregunta es, ¿cuál es?
The second question is, what are those requirements?
The mind of Moses.
The first question was, if it's true?
He wants to know
the
if
the second question is, why?
No, what? Or which one?
What is the requirement? What is the requirement to be a mekubal?
Yeah.
Yes, this is the question?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think I told you this. One time there was a boy that came here, and he told me that he wants me to teach him Kabbalah. So So I told him, first of all, the truth is it was more than one time. It was a few times like that. So I told this boy, I told him, first of all, get married.
He said, it is very important to us to know, because there's many people that proclaim themselves as, ah, me Kabbalah. Or they're going to study me Kabbalah. Also, this in internet, many Kabbalah courses, online courses.
Okay.
Like Tel Aviv.
Yeah.
Look. First of all, I will tell you what I was starting, and then we'll go on. So about this boy, I told him, first of all, get married, then learn a lot of halakha, to know halakha good, back, forward, everything clear, then we speak about Kabbalah. Okay? And what is the reason? Because someone that is not keeping halakha, or is not married, so he is very, very not protected.
No está protegido. So the woman is a protection.
The a wife, to have a wife and to be with Shalom Bayit with the wife, not only to be married, but to have Shalom Bayit.
What's the most difficult
yes.
things in the war?
It's very difficult, but it is very important. Okay? So this is that gives the person spiritual protection. Okay, so that's why one of the basic requirements to be able to learn Kabbalah seriously is to be married and also to know halakha good. Because if you don't have that, so you are open to receive a not nice presents from the other side. Okay? That's one thing. Now, second thing is that there's many requirements that are different levels, you know? So for example, in the beginning of the Siddur that I wrote, so I said...
You wrote a Siddur?
What?
You wrote a Siddur?
Yeah, you don't
what know. What is it? I don't know it. Why don't you say it to me?
Okay, and Blinda, remind me. We have it here. You come to my yeshiva. It's not a problem. But I wrote like for someone that he wants to start the way, start the process. So to be married, which can buy it. That's one thing. And to go to the mikveh, to be pure. Okay, and to keep halacha. That's the first. The first level. Then, if someone wants to do more, so there is other things. For example, not to eat meat, not to drink wine in the middle of the week. One of the requirements. So there's a list.
Why? Because of pleasure?
No.
Because you have another.
Is there a recipient
no.
for?
No. If you like, pleasure. If you like to eat yogurt with honey and it gives you pleasure, you can eat it. But meat
no.
and wine, there's a special thing.
But, wow. It connects you to this side,
to the sexuality.
No. In mitzvah, it's in mitzvah. In Shabbat, there's a mitzvah. In Shabbat, there's a mitzvah to eat wine and drink, to eat meat and drink wine.
Assume.
What? That's a different thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
But in the middle of the week, so according to the Arizal, no.
And
what? Es un cuerpo muerto.
Look.
No.
El lo es.
Pero en Shabbat lo comemos.
Es un cuerpo muerto.
No.
Mira, ahí almas. Hay almas que están guardadas que no terminan su tikkun. Y cuando el shohet le hace la shehita y la persona come eso, esas almas terminan de purgarse haciendo que una persona cumpla una mitzvah.
Es una tontería.
No,
oh,
es una tontería.
No.
Es una tontería.
En el pescado.
No.
There is a big discussion about this whole subject. I'm not getting into this. This is what there is a concept of
la que me dice que el alma de los sadikim está en los pescados. Ahora se da the soul of the sadikim is in the fish.
Mira, he escrito de que el papá se le reveló al hijo y le dijo, por favor, compra ese toro y llévalo al altar para corbán.
No sabes.
Porque estoy yo.
No sabes.
Listen. I tell you again. There's a big discussion about this.
Yeah, but neshamot are in the middle of the animal in the that we used to to the korban, to the Beit HaMikdash, and also when we do shechita, we eat for kosher, right?
Yes.
You see.
Lo sabes.
Son de bud.
Look, you're right, but you have to understand it is not so simple to elevate those neshamot.
But I want to understand why not allowed to drink wine or eat meat during the week.
So I just told you, because it is not simple to elevate those neshamot. In Shabbat you have more Sa'at HaDashmaya to elevate the neshamot. In Shabbat you can, in the week you know. We are not in the level to elevate those neshamot in the week. In Shabbat,
we are in the level.
What?
On Shabbat, we are in the level.
In Shabbat, we should be in the level.
Because we have a neshama yitera. We have two neshamot.
Sir?
How to keep the neshama yitera after Shabbat?
If you do Avdalah and you do Melav Malka, so you extend the neshama yitera longer into the week. But if you're learning Torah, Talmid Chacham, so you have something that is like neshama yitera also in the week when he's praying to Hashem. But needs a lot of work to get to this level. Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. More questions?
No.
What do you think, Kalef?
It's enough.
It's enough?
Yeah. 10 o'clock.
You want to go? You're busy?
No,
busy. We have our little sing song now.
What?
We have our sing song with Rabbi Shlomo. Okay. A little preparation for Shabbat.
Okay.
A little party, you know?
Good.
Last week.
Yeah.
Good. Enjoy.